We are here with three of the greatest players to ever play in the NBA, and also three of my main men from way back in the day. Let's talk about Run TMC. Your coach was Don Nelson, so that seemed to be perfect, because he was kind of thought outside the box to come up with whatever you guys had. You were telling me earlier you guys didn't even have a playbook, or you had a playbook, but you never used it.
We had a pretty extensive playbook, but on given nights, we would junk it. On a given night, Nelly would give us the freedom to go out there and play if we played the right way. In the locker room, he'd say, you know what, guys, tonight, I'm gonna call no plays. As long as you guys are sharing the basketball, playing the right way, no plays. And that was an incentive for us to get out there and just do just that. Tim was in charge of that because he had the ball most of the time. Tim was so good at breaking his man down. The one rule we used to give him was you can't beat your man every time the first time.
And look out, here comes the Hardaway Express.
Hardaway throws it over to Richmond with authority.
The simple rule was throw ahead, come out the other end, and then the second time you touch the ball, go do your thing.
The killer crossover. Oh, brother.
I used to just come down at sometimes at half court. You could just tell who's on the right side, who's on the left side, when you're left, when you're right. And you could just feel them just sprinting down and trying to fill the lanes and try to see who's going to get the ball first and make a layup and make a shot.
Now, the city, all of a sudden, they were all. I mean, you guys, you sold out 41 games, you sold out the whole season at one point, and then you had all these things where if you scored a certain amount of points, they got pizzas.
Pizza.
So they were in it, and they got pizzas a lot.
That's right.
Now they're screaming for pizza again. And the Warrior fans are a happy bunch. They all get free pizzas.
Gained a lot of weight out there.
Right. They were seriously into it. So it had to be just a perfect situation for all of you.
It was. I think it was just a fun time because we didn't have a problem scoring. And we came, Nelly would come in the locker room and say, hey, the first one to 125 win the game. We were like, okay, well, we got to get to 125.
Did you ever practice defense?
Yeah, actually, we did.
But your offense was your defense.
We would be playing defense, man, and we'd bust our butt. And I think I am the only one down court. Tim would throw it to me, and I'm like, I'm getting ready to dunk. And I look down, somebody said, it'd be Chris up under the ball. I'm like, how the heck did he get down there so quick? Your man didn't shoot the ball. He on the other side. How did you get down there?
I mean, the other guy contested.
He would leak out. Oh, we called the leak out. He was the best leak outer in the world. Huh?
Hey, he was always down the court. Always.
You hear
me? He'd be up under the basket. He'd get a rebound. He'd kick it out to you. Next thing you know, he'd like, hey, I'm ready. How you get down here that quick? You not that fast.
Exactly.
How'd you get down here? He always ready.